Yo, what's up guys? It's Newt, and usually I make cooking videos on TikTok and YouTube, but today
I'm with Netflix.
And today we're gonna be making the lemon cake from that one scene in Bridgerton.
Is that cake?
It is indeed.
Lemon?
Pardon?
I fancy a good lemon.
In the show, the Bridgerton family jeweler stops by Sharma's house unannounced and just starts rudely trying to eat all of their cake. If this dude took a piece of my cake?
Let's get started.
First things first, we'll preheat the oven to 350 degrees. Get a mixing bowl and add about 1 tablespoon of lemon zest. And make sure to be very careful when you're zesting, okay? Because if you ever zested a little bit too hard before, you know your fingers pay the price. Next, sift 1.5 cups of flour on top of the zest. If you don't have a sifter, I'm telling you, it's a game changer. Using a sifter prevents a lumpy batter, and we do not want a lumpy batter, okay? 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, whisk it, whisk it, whisk it. Now set that bowl aside. Get out a second bowl, immediately! This one's for the wet mix. Start with softened butter, about 1 stick or 1/2 cup, 1 cup of sugar. Then we cream the butter and sugar together. Now you could do this with a mixer or a whisk if you want to get in a workout, but the final product should look light and fluffy like this. Add in your first egg and oh, okay! Look at that egg yolk! Can we take a second to appreciate it? Because nothing excites me more than orange ass egg yolk. Chef's kiss. Egg number 2. 1 teaspoon of vanilla, close enough. Then I'm squeezing out 1/2 lemon for about 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Don't let the lemon seeds get in there because this is not a crunchy cake. Mix it all together. All right, this is the big part. We're gonna combine the dry mix to the wet mix and also add in 1/2 cup of buttermilk. But not all at once. To create a well-mixed batter, we're adding and mixing in shifts, okay? So boom, we have the wet mix, dry mix, buttermilk, stirred up. Ah, okay, you get the hang of it? Repeat. Okay, so I just got lazy here and dumped it all in, but but you can be better. I believe in you. So now this is our batter. Before pouring the batter into the loaf pan, I'm spreading the butter on the sides of the pan. Grease it up. It's kind of like I'm giving it a massage. Lay down the parchment paper to cover all sides of the pan so the cake doesn't stick. The butter helps hold the paper down. Fill the pan with our batter. Ooh, this part is so satisfying. Maybe write a little initial in there. N for Newt, N for Netflix. You can draw the heart if you want, or you can even write a secret message. Time to put it in the oven. This is gonna stay in for about 45 to 55 minutes. Do the toothpick test to see how long yours needs. After the cake comes out of the oven and cools down a little, use the parchment paper to take it out of the pan and put it on a cooling rack. While that's just sitting there, make the glaze with juice from 1 lemon, about 1/4 cup of lemon juice, and 3 tablespoons of powdered sugar. We pour that over the cake. Ah, look how it's drizzling. It looks so good. I like to put a little strawberry on the side to make mine look fancy. The flavors are melting on my tongue. You know I'm gonna make this again.